Today on Gamer's Couch.
Blueprints.
Hello.
Hello.
Welcome to the couch. Happy Sunday. It's time to talk board games, right, honey?
There's no reason to be blue. Print, whatever. Let's get the show on.
Welcome to this lovely gamer's couch. My name is Sarah. I'm the artist behind Pinselgeschichten. And this is my sweet husband, Daniel, who always interrupts me. I can do that too. I have a blue printed cup.
Yeah, but well, your cup is also green.
And white. And brown inside. Cause coffee. We're talking board games every Sunday. Today is no different. We're having bloopers on the couch. On this couch, we're starting this vlog as usual with rules and gameplay. And then we talk about what we liked or not liked about a game, and finish off with funny stories and experiences. I'm so proud of you. You didn't screw up my intro. Good boy. And now, yeah, you get meat tonight as a reward. There's going to be a lovely meat stew just for you. Anyway, we will start with rules and gameplay, and that's his part to explain. Now.
Okay. Blueprints is either a game about building submarines and trying to hide them from the government, or building buildings. I guess you guessed it, we're building buildings. So we're architects, and we try to, well, fulfill a set of blueprints that is given to us. A blueprint may look like this, an L-shaped house that is... Actually, no, that is just a house that consists of six pieces all stacked up in two rows. Or what else do we have? This more towery looking thing. So you have to put one cube here and three over there, and so on. You'll play this over three rounds, whereas each player draws one of these cards for the round. Then, because it is a very secretive game, you're not allowed to see what others are building. So you have this little, you cannot see me device, behind which you will hide your blueprint card. And now I'm showing you mine, but you haven't seen it, because it's actually behind the you don't see anything thing.
Screen. It's called a screen.
The you don't see anything thing is very important because building the building actually happens with these numbered cubes, also known as dice. And during the round, these dice will be drawn from the bag. So actually you have a couple of dice in front of you from which you can draft, and whenever you are done with drafting dice, you draw out new dice for the next player, roll them, and then they get to draft from the dice at the table. Now, what do these different dice try to tell us? Well, the transparent, translucent one is glass. Then we have orange wood, it's just go with it. Or we have ecologically very good materials. I think it just says in the manual that green dyes are good for the environment, and I don't think maybe recycled materials or something like
wheat.
And last but not least, black for stone or
concrete,
steel. I think, yeah, it's concrete. The more important thing is that different dice score differently at the end of the round. So you keep on drafting dice from this bag until you are, well, don't have any dice left. And hopefully you have built what you have to build on this thing here. Now, there's another rule that is quite important. as you can see, and with buildings in real life, you have to start at the bottom. So this is not a space station in the creation, but just a regular building. Now, you put the dice on these spaces here, and you can already see that this corresponds with what you see over here. So if it says one, then it means the one die will go on here. The two has then later on two dice over there, and three surprisingly has three dice on top of them, resulting in this building at the end. The rule you have to obey, however, is you may place any die on the first floor, but any die you want to place upon this die has to either match the number on here or have a higher number. So if you place a 5 on here, you can only place another 5 or 6 on top of it. So you could place this 5 here and then this 6 on top. After all those dice have drafted, or after you have built 6 dice in here, because all those cards are always for 6 dice, the round ends and you compare with other players and get scores. So you have this little board to keep track of the score, and whoever has the highest score for his building will get the gold card, the second highest silver, and, well, bronze. So I'm sorry, you don't see anything. Device has moved and caused quite a ruckus on the table. At the beginning of the turn, something I omitted, you have to draft 2 dice that are differently, and these are placed upon here and kind of designate the expensive, important material, preferred material that is in this game. So for example, if we have these 2 on here, that would mean that glass is in higher demand than ecologically recyclable whatever waste. Meaning that in a case of a tie between 2 players, the one who has used up the most glass gets the points, and if it's the one, if there's a tie still, you go for the second one. You will get 6 points if you correctly built the building depicted on your blueprint card. That's a given. As for the individual dice, well, that depends on what dice you were using and how they're arranged. Actually, the "You're Not Allowed to See What I'm Building" screen has a nice little depiction on how these are valued. Basically speaking, the orange dice is worth 2 points for every other orange die next to it. So you want to kind of clump them together for maximum points. The green dice are simply worth more the more you have of them. The black dice are worth as many points depending on which story you place them. So on the first floor they're only worth 2 points, but starting with the 4th floor and up, they're worth 8 points per die. And the glass dice are just worth the amount of points that is depicted on them. So if you manage to build a glass building just out of 6s, well, you guessed it, each one is worth 6. Obviously, other players are trying to compete with you for, well, the dice that are worth the most for them, or maybe that they've been using, which is why this screen is also quite handy. Not only do you see what another player has to build in terms of what his building structure looks like, if you don't pay close attention at which dice they draft, or, well, this game is 2 to 4 players, and with 4 players, maybe you already forgot which they took because you're old like us. This is a quite a handy thing to have to protect you from other people stealing the dice you desperately need. Obviously, you can still hope that the guy that goes just before you draws out new dice out of this bag, but they then have to match with the number so that you're actually able to place them, even if they're the correct material. And there you see the dilemma with playing this game. You have to kind of go for the material that might give you the most points, with ideally matching up this thing. And, well, sometimes you can't, and you have to maximize the points with whatever dice are available to draft from. To make things even more interesting, Each round, the buildings that have been built can win one of these prizes. And each prize is a little bit different. For example, this prize is given out if you manage to build a building with one of each number present on this. So it's actually like almost Yahtzeeing a street with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So that is actually quite difficult to achieve, because then you not only have to, well, you might have to pick materials that are inherently worth less for you in that turn just to manage to get that if you're going for this. Or here, you have four dice with the same number on them. Or this one, where you build a building that is five stories high. And at this point, it's actually worth mentioning, while you try to build the thing on this blueprint, you don't have to. You can actually try to build it in any way you like. So you can go for this one and nobody would know, because the screen of hiding is in front of you and they would never know. So maybe another player is also going for that. Or this one, which says you get these 2 points whenever you build a building that consists of the same material for 5 dice at least, maybe even 6, which would, for some of the dice, be actually worth a lot of points. So while the building and the dice are worth points that advance you forward on this chart, those are not the victory points for the end of the game. You essentially win by the points depicted on these prize cards. So let's say you have built the building with the most amount of whatever points and you win the gold card, that is worth 3 points. However, maybe the second placed player who wins the silver card also managed to build a house that consists of five times the same material. So he would end up with 4 victory points and actually be in the lead, despite you being the one with the most fanciest building. That's bad grammar, I know it, but I'm going to ignore it. We're not reshooting this. We are professional. And that's the game. You do this for 3 turns, where for each of the 3 turns, a different preferred material or different preferred materials are placed on here. You will get a new blueprint every time. Refill the bag. The only difference between the 2 to 4 player game is how many dice are available for draft at the same time, and therefore governing kind of how to get the most out of this bag without having to change too much for the players. Actually, in a 2-player game, you have to discard a die to kind of simulate another player as if he would have taken that die, which allows you to screw with the other players. I don't think it's in the official rules, but you can obviously also play this without the screen of hiding, which makes this a lot more, well, I'd say tactical, because you can actually see what the other player is building and try to, well, disturb them in their plans by building the most ecological house or building that tower that they want to build by always picking away the dice with the highest number on them. But be warned, the game will or might get really slow if you do that. So actually, I think we found, and that's already moving slowly over into the likes and dislikes thing and game experience, we actually found that it plays faster and a little bit more interesting with the
screen,
with the device of hiding your dice.
So let's officially hop on into the likes and dislikes Goodbye. Section. No, I want to know what you think about the game more in depth. No, not by telekinesis or no. What's
no,
it
called?
Telepathy. No, that's what I do if you're not behaving. So
let me throw that die at you. Yeah, please continue.
So, well, we got this game. I'm obviously starting with telling you what I think.
We can do the thumbs thing first and then decide if we can kind of justify our thumb.
I always can justify my thumb positioning. So, he's so distracting me. It's awful. We got this game back in 2015 at Spiel. And you have to tell me when I'm done with my two cents, if you were looking for it or if this was a happy accident of seeing it and getting the game. But I really...
Should I tell it now?
Yeah, sure.
I was looking for it.
Why?
Because I've seen a review on another quite famous channel, Shut Up and Sit Down, mm-hmm. where they talked about this. And actually, I was looking for this not necessarily because it sounded like a cool game, which it did at that point, but because of the game mechanic itself, of stacking dice. Because we have someone in our game group who's notorious for,
stacking things. Mostly dice.
Let's say obstruction of game flow by hoarding the dice and stacking them to ludicrous towers that then fall over because you kind of want to play the game and have to steal at least one of those.
Well,
and then I thought, wait a minute. I think there's a game that's actually for you.
Yeah. So, thank you for picking it up, because I really like this game. It's one of those games that I would classify as either a travel game or a filler game. It's nice and sweet and tiny. It's a dinner game, but it's also perfect for travel. There's not a lot of components that are flimsy or whatever, so that you couldn't play it, I don't know, in a hotel room on a balcony with a glass of wine or whatever. So I think it is actually particularly good as a travel game. It's fairly abstract and simple, but it's not boring. And since you always draft different dice in a different round, there's a lot of replayability, different experiences that you have while you play. It's never the same. It's pretty much in the realms of Quirkle or Scrabble, all those very abstract games that you can replay tons and tons and tons and tons and still have fun. The important thing here actually is the mechanic. That's the draw of the game, and I think it's very, very, very well executed. It's kind of a poker, bluffing, trying to steal the things you need without anybody noticing kind of a mechanic. And I really, really like it. With the theme of blueprints building buildings, yeah, that comes through by just stacking the dice. But you could have another theme maybe plastered on there. Though I think I prefer the architecture theme, so that's fun. And another good thing that I'm always very happy about is quality of the components. I love the dice. They feel like they have a metal core, though they don't. They're kind of clicky clicky heavy, you know.
They're
pretty heavy in comparison to the usual six-sided dice that you get with other games. The Don't Worry games, they're not as clicky as these games. So I really like that. And I mean, the game has my favorite color in there and one of the most important components. No, it's actually orange. So that's always a big bonus there. I'm talking about the screen and stuff in the experiences. I'm not gonna add that right about now. So what did you think, sweetheart? And how was the manual? I didn't read it.
It's short.
I know, but was it totally obvious kind of explanation, the way we like it? Or did you have to read twice?
I'm trying to remember. I think the first time we played this, we were confused about one thing, but I think that came because said player from our group played this without us first, and
they had a mishap with the rules, and there was the confusion with the seven dice putting away.
For now, for the life of me, I can't remember what it was, but yeah. I do like this, and there's actually quite a lot I like about this. First of all, I do like drafting games. And this is one where I have won more than in other drafting games. So this kind of gets higher on my list through that, which is architecturally sound in this thing. Then the second thing I very much like about this is actually the theme, because it fits really well with having to actually build something in a game about building. Although this game is rather light when it comes down to what you're actually doing, I think it is, the theme really fits to what you're doing there. I mean, you could argue with the materials, but even that, I actually like. I don't agree that this looks like wood, but I'm fine with that. It's I can see past that.
Brown is boring. Orange is cooler.
It wouldn't die. It would have been cool.
Oh yeah, that would have been awesome.
Actually, that would be a really cool deluxe version of having a wooden die and stone die.
What would you do for green? Grass? No. Wooden pallets? But that's wood.
Well, I don't know. Maybe. But whatever.
Bamboo.
The third thing I actually like very much about this, so I do like dice. I don't as much like the randomness of games when it comes to that, but I very much like creative uses of dice. And in this case, having them as building materials or as building bricks for the buildings I'm building in this building game.
Do you want me to have a counter in there? That's extra editing.
I do like the way that dice are used here. First of all, drafting dice is cool, or something I do like. And this just, comes together with all of that. I also very much like that it's not just your blueprint, but having these additional, objective cards available that you could go for, which does add a little bit more of strategic playing to this game. Do you want to go for that? Do you want to go for the highest score? And sometimes it's actually a really tough position to be in when you have to draft a die, and you know that the other player is starting to hoard those wood dies, and you know that either you start denying them, or you have to go for one of these cards in hopes that that other player is also not going for one of those cards. Or at least doesn't have then the most goods materials. Another thing I like about this, the preferred goods, those dice are essentially out of the game. So even they're not only kind of more valuable because they're on this board, they're also kind of more rare in this game, which makes them, so to speak, more expensive to use them in a building, because you know you can't... chances to get all six dice of the same type with the preferred material are actually pretty low. I like the art style. I like those illustration-like looks. There's not that much, although I have to say I actually like the art style of the blueprints themselves. It's nothing really special, but it's just cool. It's as
it's
I
well
said,
executed.
It fits the theme. Material like this bag is also pretty nice. There's not much I can say about this that I actually dislike. I mean, it's another advantage is that it is actually quite fast to play. It's I mean, the box says 30 minutes, and that's pretty much it, unless you're playing without the device of hiding your building.
Yeah, and 30 minutes, I'd say, is for four players. We played it.
Or throw it away and disturb everybody with the...
We played it faster, just the two of us. But for four players, I'd say the 30 minutes is very, very correct.
Yeah, the other thing that's a little bit... So the good thing about this game is fast. Maybe a downer, a small one due to the game being fast is... You don't get to do anything if it's not your turn, except for paying attention to what other people are doing. while that gives you a chance to memorize what they're doing, as I said, we're old, so the advantage for us is not that big.
Speak for yourself. I'm not old. I'm aged like a good wine.
It would have been cooler if there's still something to do. Although I have to say,
I would find that quite distracting.
That is,
then
that is almost the same issue we would have with Dungeon Roll, mm-hmm. and we still like Dungeon Roll.
Oh, very much
I mean,
so.
Dungeon Roll as a two-player game at least has you doing something because you still have to roll the baddies to encounter. Here, however, the only thing you do on your opponent's turn is actually pick out two more dice, roll them, and then see what they do, and that's that.
Yeah, but since the round is actually pretty fast, you need the time to memorize and keep track of what other people take with the dice so that you can make better choices in your turn.
The difference here is a round is way faster than with Dungeon Roll because you're not going into whatever, 5, 6, seven dungeons deep. And again, that it's not that bad because even if it's not your turn, you already may eye the drafting pool available to you and make the choice what you want to have, and that may be adjusted by the last or the last draw that's coming out.
Mm.
But usually you know what you're going for or think about that. So it's not too bad, but sometimes people are really annoyed by not being able to do something. So I just want to point it out. It's not a big issue for me.
No, not at all, because I'm thinking about the best move I could do and try to memorize what other people take as dice and what their facial expression is. Like, are they pissed off that because they're not having the color out there that they maybe need? Or are they actually having the smirk, meaning, oh, I got the orange one, I need the orange one, like that. So I try to focus on that if I know what I want to do and don't have any other thing to do.
If you are way smarter than we are, which is actually not that
likely.
Not that difficult, but if you want to have something to do, you can play without the hiding screen of not being able to see
but then
the other one's building.
It takes longer because you're obsessed way more.
No, the way I mean that is, and with that you get a chance to see what the others are doing during their turn, and you have something to pay attention to if you want to have something to do, and then formalize that strategy. But that only works if you're playing with people who have the discipline to actually then, when it's their turn, to just go on with their turn and not still strategize about, okay, if I did.
Yeah. So let's rate before we talk about the experiences.
Sure.
One, two, three. That's not a thumb. Thank you. So it's a full awesome there from the both of us. Let's hop into the funny stories and experiences.
Just as a I would wholeheartedly recommend this game if you like dice drafting or just want to have something light to play.
Or like stacking dice.
You can, I'm pretty sure... Maybe this is the biggest part of the game, apart from the bag, but that makes it still small enough to use it for traveling.
Yes.
I mean, you technically don't need the scoring.
No, you can count in your head and just put two dice away somewhere on the table that are the preferred materials. So, but I would very much classify this as a travel game. It's perfect. It fits in my purse, for God's sake, so I could even...
The box is a little bit bigger than you could technically fit it into half of this box.
If you leave the scoring board.
Yeah,
home.
The only thing is the scoring board, and that is only there to house the two preferred materials and, well, to keep score.
It might be a bit easier for people that are not really good with tallying up things in their head. But
I mean,
we
theoretically you could yeah. even get away with just the blueprint cards and yeah. those cards mm-hmm. Because I mean, if you just have a pen and paper, you can just keep track yes. of the score.
Yes, know. So definitely a trouble game. I wanted to talk a bit about the screen or not screen thing. So we played it with
you
two...
the device of hiding?
Yes, the two...
The stealth drive or for your building?
I'm stealth slapping you if you interrupt me once more
that
in that sentence.
That would be telekinesis.
Yes, I will. I'm training. So... what did I want to say? Oh, yeah. We played it with 2, 3, and 4 players.
It's not telekinesis if I'm closing my eyes and you hit me.
Yeah, because you can't see it coming. It is telekinesis. I'm pretty sure.
That's not how that works.
It is. I'm very sure. You don't see it coming and it happens right away. Anyway, 2, 3, and 4 players. That's what we played it with. And we played it with screen... and without the screen for all numbers of players. Because when we introduced somebody else to this game, the first round we played it without the screen just for letting people see a bit more what's happening. So we played it both ways and I liked it best with 4 players and screens. I thought, maybe it's a bit... dragging out then or a bit long with the 4 players, but it played super quick when we played it with Styx and Tina mm-hmm. with the screens. So I really, really liked that version. I liked it better than just the 2 of us playing or 3 people, like with my mom playing. So that was my favorite, and I do prefer the screen because of the speed thing and just the... I'm very curious how other people think and how they build and how they strategize. And once the screen goes away and every building is revealed, I actually really like that moment to see what other people did. If I'm kind of close with guessing what they did because of watching which dice they took. So I would, yeah, that was fun. And I like that you lose quite a bit against me, because me and the green dice, we're very good friends. Then don't disturb the mic.
Now I wanted to make an obscene joke about the building I'm building.
And now I have to tell, when you showed the blueprint cards in the beginning, there was one that very much looked like yeah. that. And when you look, when you watch back the video, you will... realize the when that happened.
Concrete meep joke. Anyway. We might have seen Deadpool yesterday, which kind of influences the type of humor we exhibit today. So
not only today.
As a free movie review, it's pretty rad, so go yeah. watch it.
Yeah. So do you remember any very cool things that happened?
I
enjoyed it.
I totally agree. I prefer the screened version versus the unscreened. So mm-hmm. I like the stealth device of hiding. And not just because it speeds up the game, but it makes the game a little bit more interesting mm-hmm. just because you don't know what the other one is going for.
Are you trying to figure out what the other one does? And then when it's revealed and you're kind of close to...
Yeah, I'm at least paying attention to what dice they pick up.
Oh, okay. So you don't try to imagine what shape they are making?
And for that reason, I think the sweet spot for me with this game would be 3 players, but I don't think that 4 players is that much different.
I liked it more with 4. The more the merrier with this one, though I wouldn't say that it would be doable with more than 4 players. I think then it would really drag out. Any other... nuggets of wisdom to add? Oh, no. If this is... Thank you. I hope the mic didn't pick that up too loud. Don't cry. You can crawl under the couch later and pick him up. Don't.
My building.
Yeah. Oh, you need Viagra for your building.
No.
No?
No.
No, we're gonna... Yeah, well, it's just... Grum. Anyway, we're gonna wrap up this video now. I'm very sorry for any...
I can totally understand if you wouldn't like this now. So this is your chance to push the dislike button and to unsubscribe.
Well, if your partner is just as weird as us, you maybe like the game even more, because then you can stack the dice pretty funnily.
Stack the dice in your favor. This is bad. We need to end this.
So thanks very much for enduring us and watching. If you have any questions or other comments, let us know in the comment section below. We will be back next Sunday on the couch with a new game. If you want to see more board game things meanwhile, check out Wednesday 9 a.m. CET Draw for Initiative, where Tina and I, our dear friend.
Okay, give me a hint. What's the next one?
We're racing.
It's the Ku Klux Klan?
Not racist. Racing, as in who's first? With animals.
Oh, it's a cooking game?
No, not a cooking game.
The Little Red Riding Hood, who's first to Grandma's house?
It's in the same family.
Mm. So it's with smelly old people?
No.
And wolves?
There's a wolf.
Oh. Nah, I'm scared of wolves. I try not to move in their vicinity. Especially not very fast.
They ow, and then you like this.
That actually sounded more like
werewolf.
No, stepping into something sharp or like
The Lego. Was the Lego
detection sound.
Detection sound. Yeah. But anyway, we're gonna paint themes or scenes of that game on Wednesday. If you know what it is, let us know in the comment section below as well. Because I'm curious if you get our very cryptic explanation of what's to come. Until then, do the good YouTube stuff, have a wonderful Sunday, and take care. Go play.
Goodbye.
With your spouse on a table, the game. Bye.